few months ago, I was lucky enough to test out the Coros Vertix, a fantastic adventure watch that could go for up to 45 days on a single charge and connect to GPS in as little as 5 seconds. Well, apparently Coros thought that it could do even better than that with a watch that can go for up to 60 days on a single charge and connect to all 5 major satellite services simultaneously. I'm Tom Dehan, reporting for a combo, and this is a Coros Vertix 2. And this is the box for the Coros Vertix 2. Now, if you've ever had the privilege of messing around with the original Coros Vertix, then you might remember that that also came in the most ludicrous box that pretty much anyone has ever seen for any tech product ever. And I'm kind of expecting the same for the Coros Vertix. So let's just dive right in. I'm being tactful here because my address and all that fun detail is on the other side of this box, so I'm trying to keep it out of view. Not that I don't trust you viewers. Actually, who am I kidding? I don't trust any of you. But, you know, I think we're still going to have some fun taking a look at this. Ooh. Yeah, I tell you what. This is kind of impressive. Let's have a look. Yeah, this is... I tell you what, you'd think that this was like a lunchbox, just a really, really fancy lunchbox. This is, I'm not even sure how to open this looking at it. Oh wait, I think it might be here. So if I, there we go. Right, let's see. What are we working with? Ooh, whoa, check that out. I tell you what, no one does unboxings like Coros, it has to be said. So I say we work in reverse here and we build up to the main event. Let's start with the watch straps over here. Now, as you can see, we have been sent the orange watch straps. There is a gray slash brown alternative, but let's be honest, these just look so much nicer. They really jump out. They are pretty much exactly the same color as the similar watch bands for the original Vertix. And from what I can tell, the same material as well, but that's not really an issue given how sturdy the original Vertix was. This thing, yeah, you can hear there. I mean, I'm destroying the box in the process, but it proves my point. The Vertix range is all about durability, and this material, it's, yeah, it's tough stuff. That's not going anywhere anytime soon. Let's see, I see a little bit of paneling here. Ooh. Check this out. I'll tell you what, let's put this over to the side for a second and see what's going on in here. So it looks like we've got a cheeky little charging cable. If I open that up. Now, you might know if you've used a Coros watch before that these devices have a proprietary charging cable. Let's see, should be able to see it there. It's not too dissimilar to the one that Garmin uses, but the tiny little prongs are a little bit more indented, so sadly those Garmin ones aren't going to work here, just amongst the Coros range. But you know what, for the features you get here, it's not the worst thing in the world. And let's see, we also have a user guide, which I can tell is the thing that everyone looks forward to the most whenever they get a new piece of tech. They're like, listen, forget the product, I just want to sit here and read all this stuff. That's why I'm here. Ooh, check this out though. Little quick start guide there for setting it up, all fun stuff, but a couple of, well, that's a support thing, but a couple of stickers there. That's quite nice. It's always, yeah, anything like that where a company just throws in a little bit extra, I think is always quite a nice thing to see, because it so rarely happens that it just feels like company has made more of an effort. So I say let's try and reassemble this box slightly, bring this back over here. Good, nothing seems to have broken yet. I'll tell you what, the box is probably as sturdy as the watch. Speaking of the watch, let's dive into the main star of the show itself, Coros Vertix 2. Now let's get ready to explore perfection, so sit down and don't stand up. Is that the right saying? I don't know. Anyway, let's see. Yeah, I tell you what, this looks very similar to the original Vertix watch. The coloration is a bit different. This has a lighter gray around the side, which I have to say looks quite nice. It has very nice style to it. And in terms of weight, maybe slightly lighter than the original Vertix, which feels like a bit of an absurd thing to think or even say, given how much extra that they crammed into this thing. So no longer is it 45 day battery life, it's now 60 day battery life. Yes, 2 months on a single charge. Plus, you've now got offline music storage with 32 gigabytes in the device itself. And, yep, there's more to this, and offline maps, so that if you do get lost and you don't have your phone on you, then this little guy will help you get back to where you need to be. These are just some of the features that they've crammed into this thing, and you know what? I'm really looking forward to testing this out, so I say, let's just get on with it. And here it is, the Coros Vertix 2 in the flesh, all set up and ready to go. Now, the first thing I want to show you, because it was the, well, thing that I immediately noticed, was the change in the UI. So if you scroll upwards, you start to see different, I guess, you could say rows of what is going on under the surface. And I tell you what, from first glance, it's very similar to what Garmin uses on, particularly on its Venue smartwatch line, where everything is neatly compact. So for instance, notifications here, nothing's happened yet because I'm just not being messaged today, which I tell you what, makes for quite a nice change. Got your training app here. Let's see, temperature, weather, all this sort of stuff. It's in one easy to read sort of section, as opposed to how it was on the original Vertix watch, where you would scroll past from plane to plane, and it probably all felt a bit disjointed. Sure, it was maybe a little bit easier to read, but it was harder to get exactly, or rather harder to get straight to the thing that you wanted to see, whereas now it's just easier because there's less time spent scrolling through. So the next thing I really want to show you is, if we head over to the main menu, it's right here. It's the heart rate variability test. Now, I'm not going to run this now because it takes about a minute to do so, and that would just be really boring for you to watch, but it's a great feature to have, particularly if you've had any experience with it before. It features mostly on the Whoop Strap 3.0, and the concept of heart rate variability and why you should pay attention to it is that it's a key metric for understanding where your body is in relation to recovery. So it gives you a better idea of when you are primed and ready to get back into training and, yeah, doing what you do best on a workout. And finally, it's made its way to the Vertix. Now, if we keep scrolling, you shall see in a moment, one of the big new features that's come to the Vertix 2 is music. Don't have anything stored on here just yet, but it is great to see that offline music playback has finally made its way to the Vertix. Now, unfortunately, it's not quite as robust as it is on, say, the Apple Watch or even the Garmin Venue 2. Reason being is that you can't use this with a Spotify account. It has to be with locally stored MP3 files. So you would have to hook this up to a computer, transfer the files over directly to the watch, and then you're ready to go. It's not the best case scenario, but it's certainly a marked improvement over, well, the complete lack of any sort of music playback on the original Vertix. Probably one of the more surprising additions here, however, is the ability to work with some Insta360 cameras directly on the watch, particularly the Insta360 One X2 and the Insta360 One XR. I believe I got those right there. Such a mouthful to say. But with this functionality built in, you can now control playback and recording directly on the watch. So if you're the type of person who enjoys vlogging whilst hiking or going out for a run, then this is going to be a major boon just in helping you get the footage that you want when you need it at a moment's notice. It's going to be a huge feature, I think, and a lot of people are probably going to gravitate towards this watch for this functionality. And that was your first look at the Coros Vertix 2. Don't forget to subscribe to avoid missing out on our full in-depth take on the watch. And if you have any questions, then please let us know in the comments below.